In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Dear friends, we gather on this first Friday, honoring the most sacred heart of our Lord, a heart that beats for us, a heart that pours love over us, a love that we would like to imitate. We offer this Eucharist for the intentions that have been entrusted to us and those that we hold dear in our hearts. Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. Clothe us, Lord God, with the virtues of the heart of your Son, and set us aflame with his love, that, conformed to his image, we may merit a share in eternal redemption. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen. Please be seated.
A reading from the book of the prophet Amos. Hear this, you who trample upon the needy and destroy the poor of the land. When will the new moon be over, you ask, that we may sell our grain, and the Sabbath, that we may display the wheat? We will diminish the containers for measuring, add to the weights, and fix our scales for cheating. We will buy the lowly man for silver, and the poor man for a pair of sandals. Even the refuse of the wheat we will sell. On that day, says the Lord God, I will make the sun set at midday and cover the earth with darkness in broad daylight. I will turn your feasts into mourning and all your songs into lamentations. I will cover the loins of all with sackcloth and make every head bald. I will make them mourn as for an only son and bring their day to a bitter end. Yes, days are coming, says the Lord God, when I will send famine upon the land, not a famine of bread or thirst for water, but for hearing the word of the Lord. Then shall they wander from sea to sea and rove from the north to the east in search of the word of the Lord, but they shall not find it. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
One does not live by bread alone, but by every word that comes from the mouth of God.
One does not live by bread alone, but by every word that comes from the mouth of God.
Blessed are they who observe his decrees, who seek him with all their heart.
One does not live by bread alone, but by every word that comes from the mouth of God.
With all my heart I seek you. Let me not stray from your commands.
One does not live by bread alone, but by every word that comes from the mouth of God.
My soul is consumed with longing for your ordinances at all times.
One does not live by bread alone, but by every word that comes from the mouth of God.
The way of truth I have chosen. I have set your ordinances before me.
One does not live by bread alone, but by every word that comes from the mouth of God.
Behold, I long for your precepts. In your justice, give me life.
One does not live by bread alone, but by every word that comes from the mouth of God.
I gasp with open mouth in my yearning for your commands.
One does not live by bread alone, but by every word that comes from the mouth of God. Please stand.
Is a lamp for my feet and a light on my path. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
As Jesus passed by, he saw a man named Matthew sitting at the customs post. He said to him, "Follow me." And he got up and followed him. While he was at table in his house, many tax collectors and sinners came and sat with Jesus and his disciples. The Pharisees saw this and said to his disciples, "Why does your teacher eat with tax collectors and sinners?" He heard this and said, "Those who are well do not need a physician, but the sick do. Go and learn the meaning of the words, 'I desire mercy, not sacrifice. I did not come to call the righteous, but sinners.'" The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated.
Magandang tanghali po sa ating lahat. We gather as a community to honor the most sacred heart of Jesus on this first Friday of the month. Kahapon po ako ay dumalaw sa mga patients of the Ruth Foundation. So they look after people needing palliative care, but those who are in the fringes of our society. No? May nabisita ko na tatlong grupo. Isang middle-aged woman who is paralyzed and needing attention. A 5-year-old kid with terminal cancer. And a sibling, sisters, who have terminal illnesses as well. They don't have people to look after them. And so the foundation looks after these people. As I was going back home last night driving, I was so overwhelmed by the situation that I found that I started to cry. And the reading from the prophet Amos today was spot on, making me feel or making me put into words the feeling that I had yesterday. Hear this, you who trample upon the needy and destroy the poor of the land. Mga kapatid, ang puso ni Jesus ay isang puso na nagdurugo para sa ating lahat. Yes. But Jesus' heart is a heart that bleeds first and foremost for the needy, for the poor. It's a heart that beats with love for the poor and the needy. This is the heart that we honor every first Friday. And the best way to honor this heart of the Lord is to love the way He loves. To have that special love, a special place for those who are most in need, for those who are poor, for those who are neglected. The prophet Amos, in our first reading today, was reminding the people who have forgotten about the God who lifted them up from the dung heap dahil nakatikim lamang sila ng ginhawa. Mga nakalimot sa biyaya ng Diyos na lahat ng tinatamasa nila ay galing lamang sa biyaya ng Diyos. Those who trample upon the needy, those who destroy the poor of the land. Ideally, when the world experiences prosperity, everyone should experience prosperity. But we know for a fact, and we know by experience, that that is not the case. And so the antidote to that, dear friends, is to be reminded that the heart that we honor every first Friday, the most sacred heart of our Lord, is a heart that beats specially for those who are neglected. In our gospel today, this is the same heart that looked at Saint Matthew, a miserable person, and yet chosen because of the love of our Lord. I desire mercy, the Lord says. Ang pag-ibig ng mahal na puso ng Diyos ay mercy. The heart of the love, the heart of the most sacred heart of Jesus, the love of the most sacred heart of Jesus is mercy. A mercy that we experience, a mercy that turns into generosity, especially for those who are most in need. And so we continue with this Eucharist, asking the Lord to give us a part of that heart, His most sacred heart, so that our hearts may beat for those that He loves the most. Yes, the Lord loves us all, but He has a special care and a special love for those that we neglect, the world neglects. And so in this Eucharist, we specially remember those people. We ask that the Lord's heart may pour His grace upon our hearts so we can love like Jesus. Amen.
Please stand.
Christ came to call sinners, offering them salvation. With humility of spirit and aware of His call, let us bring our prayers to the Father.
That the Church may be seen as the healing home of the weak and the sinful, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those who hold public office may be honest and faithful to their duties, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That in this Eucharistic offering, we may experience God's healing mercy, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That we may look with compassion and understanding to those persons who are living sinful lives. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the dead may experience the saving power of God. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
In silence, we pray for our own intentions. Father, with the faith of Abraham, you followed your call. Who followed your call, your Christian people bring their prayers to you. Grant what you inspire us to ask through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Please be seated. Please stand.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Look, O Lord, we pray, on the surpassing charity in the heart of your beloved Son, that what we offer may be a gift acceptable to you, and an expiation of our offenses, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For raised up high on the cross, he gave himself up for us with a wonderful love, and poured out the blood and water from his pierced side, the wellspring of the church's sacraments, so that won over to the open heart of the Savior, all might draw water joyfully from the springs of salvation. And so, with all the angels and saints, we praise you, as without end we acclaim.
Holy, holy, Holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Please kneel.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
Please stand.
The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit.
Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Jose, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer one another a sign of Christ's peace. Peace be with you.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Please kneel.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are we who are called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Please stand.
Let us pray. Made partakers in your sacrament of charity, we humbly implore your mercy, Lord, that we may be conformed to Christ on earth and merit to be co-heirs of his glory in heaven, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
Kindly be seated for a while. We would like to greet all of you a blessed afternoon as we celebrate the first Friday of the month of July, and we gather this afternoon as we offer and dedicate our Holy Mass and ourselves to the Most Sacred Heart of Jesus. And in a very special way, we would like to thank our priests who celebrated the Mass with us. We've gone international this afternoon, and our visitors, our priests, are from places that are also dear to us, and they come here to the Manila Cathedral to visit this place and to experience home in our midst. And we would like to begin with our Mass presider, and maybe some of you are already familiar with him. Once in a while during his vacation from his diocese, he would normally celebrate Mass with us. And with us this afternoon is Reverend Father DJ Sugitan, the Assistant Priest of the Sacred Heart Cathedral in Bendigo, Victoria, Australia. Father DJ, welcome back and maraming salamat po. Just so you know, Father DJ was a former Manila seminarian, and the cathedral is also close to his heart whenever during their time would serve the archbishops during Christmas and other celebrations. That is why the cathedral is close to his heart, and talaga naman pong he would come home whenever time permits him. So maraming salamat po muli, Father DJ. And with us are four priests from Vietnam, from the Diocese of Long Xuyen. And we have with us Father Michael, another Father Michael, Father Joseph, and Father Anthony. Welcome to the Manila Cathedral, Father. Father Michael, the one who spoke with Father DJ during the Eucharistic prayer, came already to the cathedral, I think, several times, and the three other priests came over here today for the very first time, and we would like to welcome all of them and greet with all our hearts. Kaya po, fathers, welcome to the cathedral, and thank you very much for celebrating the noontime Mass with our faithful brothers. And together with Father Michael are our brothers from the Focolare Movement, Gens, from Tagaytay, headed by Brother JP. So welcome po, Father, brothers. And again, thank you once again for your presence this afternoon. Be blessed with the presence of our dear fathers, and bring with you the blessings of the Sacred Heart of Jesus. Maraming salamat po, and we now receive the blessing.
Please stand.
Maraming salamat po, Father Viel, and thank you, fathers. Come on. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Bow your heads and pray for God's blessing. May God bless you with every heavenly blessing, make you always holy and pure in his sight, pour out in abundance upon you the riches of his glory, and teach you with the words of truth, may instruct you in the gospel of salvation, and ever endow you with fraternal charity through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
And may the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit come down on you and remain with you forever.
Amen.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God.
Have a lovely afternoon.
Ipinagliging walang sana.
Jesus.